This week, we might have bitten off more than we can chew.
I've put the house up for sale behind his back twice.
This is fascinating.
With obstacles to tackle on both sides.
A loft extension would take you way over your budget.
And a lot of boxes to tick.
Let's get your work cut up for you.
It's time to move.
Will we get this family their happy ending?
Are you going to love it?
Or list it?
Today we're in Cheshire, in the northwest of England, home to celebrities, footballers, and some of the highest house prices in the country.
I'm always a bit daunted by the prospect of going house hunting in Cheshire because it is so expensive.
Well, it's a nice neck of the woods.
Yeah, and there's endless celebs who live in Cheshire.
I know, you'd be in good company. Oh, look, that's a rather fetching-looking birdhouse type of thing.
I'd be in good company.
Yes, well, you're a celeb, aren't you, Filmer?
But we're not here to rub shoulders with Phil's celebrity pals. Today, we're meeting cinematographer Jabs and his actress wife, Sarah, at their four-bed semi in the leafy Cheshire suburbs.
We met in church. I just saw him across the room and thought, he's gorgeous. Didn't expect to see such a gorgeous guy in church.
And she chased me for years.
That's a lie.
They were married in 2012 and have two children. Josiah, 12.
Oh, bummer, oh my.
And Mimi Ray, who's 9.
It's not going to be the biggest house in the world.
The couple both lead very busy lives.
You've got to finish your veg, though.
As do their children, taking part in a variety of social activities. So finding a home with a nice community and close to excellent schools was top of their priority list when they bought this house in 2017.
I think when we moved here, we saw the house and we thought, well, there's a lot we could do to it to kind of make it our home. I mean, if you'd seen it at first, it was an absolute mess.
The kitchen was really dated.
Yeah.
But the area was perfect. It's just a very community-oriented,
yeah.
Very safe.
It was close to the schools we wanted the kids to go to as well.
So in the last 5 years, they've removed a wall to create a modern kitchen diner, installed bifold doors and tidied up the garden to make it more family friendly. But because the living space is now completely open plan, there's nowhere to hide the washing machine. And the laundry has to be dried in this space too.
Can you move further up down there?
Which Sarah is not happy about.
This house just isn't working for me anymore. Clothes just appear everywhere. We desperately need a second bathroom.
Mimi, I need to brush my teeth.
And I think it's fair to say that there's a very short amount of storage.
But after doing a lot of the work so far himself, Jabs has become attached to this house.
I love this house because the kids are happy here and there's loads of room outside in the garden. I love the fact that it's not overlooked and the community and the area is very nice as well. I think our money's better spent on improving what we already have.
As well as their new open-plan kitchen family room, Sarah and Jabs also have a separate sitting room at the front of the house, which has recently become Josiah's gaming room. On the first floor are two bedrooms and a box room, as well as the only family bathroom. Then there's the fourth bedroom in the loft, but there's an issue with that.
We've got these horrible stairs, which are kind of like called space saver stairs, which...
really old school.
Really nearly stopped me from putting an offer in, but we thought we'll be able to sort that, and we've not managed to.
Meaning the 15 square metre loft space can only be used as a dumping ground and occasional playroom. And despite wanting to stay, Jabs can see that the stairs aren't the only thing that needs to change.
I do agree with Sarah that there are issues with the house, especially with the bathroom situation. And we don't have enough storage, especially with me working in media. I've got a lot of equipment that I need to be able to store somewhere and also just having a quiet place to be able to work.
So they both acknowledge the problems, but the debate over how to solve them has been raging for 3 years.
Move this out of the way.
I think what we disagree on is the fact that we have to move. I don't think we have to move. I just think we need to solve the issues. She thinks we need to move.
Yes.
I think that's where we come in.
Come on, old lady.
What did you just say?
You're just taking your time, that was all. Those creaky bones.
Hello.
Hello.
Nice
morning.
To see you.
Nice
Nice to see you. Come in.
Thank you very much.
Creaky bones. Count yourself lucky they've answered the door so quickly, Spencer.
Who wants to love? Who wants to list?
I would like to list.
I want to love.
How long have you lived here?
Five years.
But, Sarah, yes. You didn't particularly like it then?
No. I loved the area. I loved the south-facing garden. I loved the potential, but I could see all the flaws.
So has this debate about whether to love or list been going on for 5 years?
Yes.
Well, for
about
3 years.
I put the house up for sale behind his back twice.
This is fascinating.
She's sneaky, she is, honestly.
I just thought if he could see what's out there, he might be persuaded to move.
Like I say to her, I said, every problem has a solution, you know, so it's just a way of figuring out and coming to a compromise.
I want to go and have a look
around. Can we have a look around?
Yes, of course.
This debate has obviously been brewing for a long time, and neither Sarah nor Jab seem willing to back down. But I get the feeling this won't be a straightforward resolution.
It's a good kitchen, not quite how I would have laid it out. But I can see their issues. Washing in the middle of the room. They must be dealing with that day in, day out, because there's no utility room. There's no downstairs loo. It just doesn't work.
And while there is a separate reception room at the front of the house, it's currently doubling up as a teenage gaming room as well as a home office for Jabs.
It's one of those houses where it's a combination of busy family, so if the house had a bit more love, it would probably improve. But also, the space just isn't working for them. I think this is just a bit of imagination, some decent carpentry, and a lick of paint. It's amazing what you can do.
A few quick fixes might well help with downstairs, but I've a feeling the bedrooms might cause you more of a problem.
This would be the main bedroom. Again, no storage. That's the only wardrobe. And that's for a couple. I mean, that's just not going to work. Deary me. Fortunately, it's not going to be my problem. This is obviously their son's room with a big wardrobe. And actually, they're all sharing that wardrobe simply because there isn't enough storage space next door. Kirstie loved sorting out storage. So I'm sure she can help there. But even if she manages to resolve that, still doesn't have a utility room and it's still only got one bathroom. Which means it's time to move.
With my Love It budget of £45,000, I'm sure I'll be able to solve most of the problems. Though I'm less confident about this loft room.
I mean, you could put a dormer on here, but even then, it's not a proper bedroom. Unless you had the sort of bed bit in here and you made it a sort of mezzanine with the bedroom downstairs for the adults. I don't think that's really practical, so I think Jabs is too tall. No, this isn't a viable space. And you couldn't really come up and down here with equipment.
Whereas I have a budget of £550,000 to find them a new home that's better suited to their busy lives.
But it will be difficult to get a bigger house for that budget in this neck of the woods. And with stamp duty at £15,000 and moving costs just under £8,000, that's almost £23,000 that could be invested in this house to make it better suit their needs. I just need to work out the best way to do that.
I mean, it's a bit of a shame because this is a lovely room.
Yeah.
But they've overcooked it and made it too big.
They don't have a table in here, which suggests they don't do a lot of entertaining. Children have activities outside the house, etc., etc. So this is just a kitchen for a life they don't lead.
Well, just rearrange it. It could work.
This could come back to here. Literally, could start here. And this could be a laundry and a wet room.
It can definitely be improved. But then equally, there'll be lots of other things out there that offer four bedrooms, two bathrooms.
Yeah, because it's such a good market at the moment. You can find whatever you want and there's no bidding wars and it's really easy to find property.
You let me worry about that. Let the games commence.
Everything's a game to you, isn't it, Phil?
Interesting conundrum. I see the dilemmas very clearly. And I'm looking forward to doing the search. But can we just talk about what it is you're looking for, Sarah, and indeed what it's going to take to shift you?
Well, I'm looking for something with more space. I want a nice big bedroom where I can put my clothes in a big wardrobe.
There's not many of those out there, are there?
No. And a second bathroom and a utility. So I'm not asking for a lot.
Anything else?
Well, I think to move me, it's got to be
detached.
Yeah, detached, remote.
When you say remote, you mean privacy?
Privacy, yeah. So get your work cut out for you.
Yeah, no, I realise. I think we've both got to work hard. Yeah, but that's that is high time it got sorted.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
Right.
Well, there we go. Battle lines are drawn.
Well, I don't see them as battle lines. Okay. Though.
You've got a long list to sort out.
Yeah.
I'm taking quite a lot of comfort that Sarah's never liked the house.
I'm extremely excited to find out what Kirstie's got in store for us. And I think Sarah will be easily persuaded, I think, most definitely.
I've got to work out what's TLC, what's building work, and what's just a need for storage. Yeah.
We'll find out.
I'm interested to see what plans she comes up with, but I don't think she's going to be able to gain me the space that I want, with even with her clever planning.
That sounds like a challenge, Sarah.
I feel fed up with this house.
In Cheshire, Sarah and Jabs have been arguing over whether to love or list their four-bed semi for 3 years.
I think Sarah wants to list it because I think she just wants the easy way out, but that's not the reality.
So while I have a budget of £550,000 to find a more spacious house that's still close to the children's schools...
Get your work cut up for you.
Yeah, no, I realise.
I have £45,000 to create more room for them at home.
They just genuinely need more storage.
However, with building costs and materials at an all-time high, there's no way that budget will stretch to cover everything I know they're hoping for. I don't think Sarah's going to like it, but it's time for some tough love.
You can't live in this house as it is now. There's not enough space for stuff, and no, it's impossible to keep it tidy, and it's it's just not practical.
No.
But basically, we are heading towards pretty troubled waters economically.
Yes, really. Yeah.
And I'm in a super, super cautious phase as far as advising anyone. Mm. What we want to do is make the most of this beautiful kitchen, which you spent a lot of money on, but a lot of this job is carpentry. So...
Starting with the ground floor, I'm stretching their budget to just under 48k and proposing a small extension to the side of the house with enough space for a laundry and shower room. If they did decide to stay for the long term, this could then be extended further to create an additional office for Jabs. But for the moment, we'll implement storage solutions in the existing sitting room to make it a more functional space for gaming and working from home. Upstairs will incorporate better storage to make the most of the space they have in each room. The cheapest way to address the loft stairs issue would be to widen and lengthen the staircase by taking some space from the bedrooms. This would cost at least £3,000, but the extra space could really ease the pressure on other parts of the house. And with Mimi Ray keen to make the loft room her room, it could be a win-win.
There's nothing I want more than to come and say, ta-da! But a loft extension would take you way over your budget.
Yeah.
A double-storey extension would take you way over your budget.
Yeah.
But this house, with the right storage, would be a revelation. Listen, you can decide to spend more and I can incorporate that in any plan.
Yeah.
But this isn't a finite thing.
No.
This is just making it function really well and make it really saleable.
Yeah.
And then you try living with it, and then if you turn around and say, actually, no, I want to go, then this is tip-top, ready to sell.
I will be mulling over this now.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry.
It's OK, we've got to be realistic. Thank you.
Pleasure, treasure. Of course Sarah's disappointed. She wanted more from this build. But if she truly wants to sell it, she needs to make it look immaculate and not spend too much money. Whether I can persuade her to stay is a whole other issue.
Kirstie's not managed to sway me at all. After looking at the plans, I'm really now more eager to move.
Visually, once you've seen when everything's done, she's going to want to stay.
Don't be so sure, Jabs. Now that Sarah knows this house will never give her what she wants, I think she'll be keener than ever to move.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Good, thank you.
Just before we set out on the search, just remind ourselves the key things that are important. 550 is the budget.
Yep.
Yeah.
Access to the schools. Definitely a second bathroom. Definitely some utility space or storage. It can't be that complicated.
Like we're miracles.
Come on.
Exactly.
Jabbed you in a whole pile of trouble.
Just we'll see.
Let's go.
My first offering is this charming four-bedroom semi in the sought-after village of Appleton Thorne, less than 20 minutes from the children's schools. On the market for offers over £450,000, it's £100,000 under budget, and it's 23% bigger than their current home.
Right. First throw of the dice, see what you think of this. It's got parking, it's got a garage, it's in a nice quiet street, villagey feel, it's close to schools.
It's lovely. It's definitely got that curb appeal and nicely presented, isn't it?
It does look very nicely presented, yeah. Very well kept.
Okay. I thought it was a good place to start.
Okay.
Let's get in.
So far, so good with the smart exterior. And what's inside is even more impressive.
Come on, then. Let's see what you think of this. This is arranged at the moment as the living room. It doesn't have to remain the living room.
Yeah.
No, OK.
As we go through, I want you to think quite carefully that this is 100 grand under budget.
Isn't it?
This is 450.
Wow. Wow.
But let's have a look.
OK.
OK.
With a country-style kitchen, a conservatory and family room, and a separate lounge that's 30% larger than theirs at home, the family would have plenty of space to spend time together without feeling on top of one another. There's also a downstairs WC and access to the garage via the house, so the utilities could be kept out of the kitchen.
Oh, I love the conservatory
and the garden. Can't help but look at the garden as well.
I wondered whether this could be the living room.
Mm.
Okay. And actually, the dining table goes in the front room. We haven't got the open plan space here that you've got at home. That's the rub.
Yeah.
But you've got 100 grand in your budget. If you wanted to rejig things, you could create the open plan.
Yeah.
Jab's just he looks so unimpressed.
He doesn't want to do any work.
I told you, it takes a lot to impress me.
Why don't you have a quick squiz upstairs, see what you think?
Yeah.
And then we'll meet up out.
Okay.
Upstairs, there's a generous family bathroom, and four good-sized bedrooms would provide all the space they need. There's plenty of storage space, which was one of Sarah's top priorities.
Oh, wow. It's so spacious.
Yeah, not bad.
Loads
of
storage.
That's exactly what she wanted, though,
isn't it? She's got space to get changed, plus three wardrobes. Nice view.
Road looks quiet.
I really like this room.
Yeah,
should we have a look at the rest of the house?
OK, come on then.
Well, my impressions are that they are sticking to type so far. Sarah is viewing with a positive mindset. She's trying to think for solutions, whereas Jabs isn't. He is very entrenched into Team Lover. He doesn't want to move, so I guess I shouldn't be surprised.
Now, this is really nice. Oh, it's got the bath that you want, the freestanding bath.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and a shower.
This is really well done, isn't
so it? So nicely done, yeah. And we've got the downstairs toilet as well. It's really nice.
Yeah, it is good.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I like the bath. The bathroom is probably the best bit so far.
Well, Jab seems to have perked up at the sight of a big bath. I'll have to keep that in mind for the rest of my search.
How did you get on up there?
There's enough space, I think, definitely.
It's 25% bigger than yours is.
Yeah,
is it?
It is. I can tell already.
Yeah.
And this garden.
Yeah. I wanted to show it to you because I think it's charming. It demonstrates the space that you need is out there. It's affordable in the areas that you like.
It is, and it ticks a lot of boxes. It's got a lot of things that we haven't got. The only thing that we've got that it's not is the open plan kitchen.
But leave it with me. You've got extra money in your budget.
Yeah.
And we've got a bit of time to play with, so yeah. I'm determined to find you something that's going to put ticks in all those boxes. But for now, let's move on.
OK.
Thank you. I think swaying Jabs to come on to Team Lister is going to be a very, very hard task.
She knows me well. Mr. Stubborn.
Looks as though you've got your work cut out for you, Phil. And 4 months since we first met, Jabs and Sarah are also hard at work.
I think that goes there on the second two holes.
After a drawn-out process looking at different options, the skyrocketing cost of renovating have put a stop to my idea of an extension. Sarah and Jabs have reduced their budget to a very sensible £10,000 and are using it to go ahead with my ideas for storage and maximising space within the house as it is.
When Kirstie first came round, she mentioned that I think the main issue that we had was storage.
Got to learn to let go.
So we've taken that on board and we decided against having the extension, and we've kind of gone with Kirstie's idea of having more storage in the house.
As planning permission would be required and building estimates came back high, the new staircase is also on the back burner. But Mimi Ray is still keen to move up to the loft bedroom, which frees up the box room to become a walk-in wardrobe, gaining them an additional 4 square metres of much-needed storage space.
Once the wardrobes are in, I think that's going to completely change our lifestyles, to be able to all go in there and be able to get changed. I think even the kids will use it and stop using mine. They were in my bedroom.
It might not give Sarah exactly what she wants, but given the current climate, reducing their investment is very wise. And if they decide to stay, then spending on the extension and stairs at a later stage will make much more sense.
But if I can find them a more suitable house that ticks all the boxes right now, I think they'll find it hard to resist.
I've still got a lot of work to do to convince Japs to even consider moving, but that being said, I have got some good houses up my sleeve to show them, which I'm hoping, and keeping fingers and toes tightly crossed, should be enough for them to put the house up for sale. Ideally with Japs' permission this time.
My second offering is slightly further from home, in the village of Colchester. So I'm taking a risk because this isn't their preferred area, but I do think it's important to show Sarah and Jabs what they could get for their money by widening the search just a couple of miles. On the market for offers over £500,000, this recently renovated, detached four-bedroom house is within budget and offers almost 30% more space than they have at home.
Right, well, let's see what you think of this. We are just round the corner from the Village High Street.
Okay.
Quiet road, parking, big detached house.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm quite impressed at the outside, but like I want to say, see what's on the inside.
I completely accept it is further than perhaps you wanted to be.
Yeah. Mm.
But it's a fantastic example of what your money could buy you.
It's beautiful.
Come on.
While the first house we saw was lacking the open-plan living space Sarah and Jabs are used to, this one has that well and truly covered with this vast kitchen diner and adjoining snug. On top of that, there's also a separate sitting room, a ground floor office, and the WC and utility that they're now not going to get at home.
Right, folks. Big wide hallway. Office through there.
Wow.
Adult sort of living room in there.
Oh, my.
Massive kitchen.
Wow. Oh, it's amazing.
Mm. Is this open plan enough for you?
It's a dream house.
I wouldn't say dream house. It is very good, though.
So this is an example, 500,000. It's a little bit further away from the schools than perhaps you'd like, but it's close to the high street, it's got parking, it's got a lot going for it. Jabs is looking worried!
I'm not worried. I'm impressed, but I'm not worried yet.
Go on, you need to see some more.
Look at that.
Upstairs, there are 4 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, and loads of storage space.
Oh, my gosh. Wow. Oh, Jabs, it's so nice. Oh, it's so much space.
And the storage.
Oh.
Is this storage? What's in here?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
That's really good size. Dressing table, big window.
It's a good space. I like it.
Well, lots of positivity up there, just as I'd hoped. They are loving it. This has knocked it out of the park. This is proper back-of-the-net stuff. As a house. I'm a bit less sure on the area, though.
Okay.
This is nice. And an ensuite. Oh, my gosh.
Its own separate area, isn't it?
Yeah. I don't want to get too excited because we're too far from the schools, but we couldn't get anything like this in the areas that we're looking
at. No, it's true, we couldn't. It's good to see what you can get for your money.
Yeah.
So, gang,
What do you think upstairs?
I mean, it's just a dream house.
I don't care what Kirstie does. It's not going to look like this, is it?
No, it's not. It is really nice. But there's a lot of things about it that still... Garden small.
Yeah.
Distance.
Yeah. It's such a shame because everything else is just perfect. Mm.
Let's bear in mind, this is 500,000, your budget's 550.
Yeah.
It's a little bit further than you were hoping for.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But it is an example. You're not going to get everything, but we can get pretty close.
Yeah.
And this all boils down to what's more important, the practicalities and needs of the family out of the house or the area?
I've got a lot of thinking to do, weighing up what it is we really need from a house.
Dabs, how about you?
Well, slowly getting there. I can see my eyes are opening slowly.
Quite. It does take a while, doesn't
yeah.
it?
I told you, I'm stubborn.
As long as they're opening, as long as they're
opening. Yeah, they are opening.
I will get back to you as soon as I find something a little bit closer.
Okay.
Okay.
Great.
Yeah.
I have every faith.
Well, I would say this goes to show that they can have it all. They just can't have it all where they currently are. What matters more? The right location or a house that ticks all the boxes? That's what we're going to find out.
I'm not sure either of them is willing to compromise just yet, Phil. It looks like we're both facing an uphill struggle to settle this love it or list it debate. In the leafy Cheshire suburb, Sarah and Jabs have been battling for 3 years over loving or listing their four-bed semi.
I am still team love it because I think we're doing so much work on this house, giving it so much love. I don't see what the point of ditching it and moving somewhere else.
But having been forced to scale back their plans for an extension with utility and second bathroom, Sarah is standing strong on team list it.
I am not budging. I know there's these little nuggets of things that I'm really excited about, but it's still just making the best out of the situation that we've got, and I'm not happy with the space.
So with a budget of £550,000, I'm hard at work on the hunt for a house that ticks all the boxes.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, Jabs, it's so nice.
But that budget isn't going to be enough to buy the perfect house in an area close to the children's schools. So I'm focused on making the most of what they have at home. And after 5 months of quotes and reversions due to the increase in building costs, my original plan is on hold, so I'm back to help come up with a more cost-effective solution.
Looking around, a good start for this house would be a bit of a tidy-up out here. Repainting the gates, perhaps repainting the doors. Maximum impact, minimum spend.
Having decided to reduce their budget to £10,000, the ground floor extension is no longer an option. But I'm confident we can still make these bedrooms work better without overspending. The plan for this room is to turn it into a dedicated dressing room, freeing up space in the main bedroom and making sure the family don't all have to share the wardrobe in Josiah's room.
If you've got a spare bedroom, turning it into a giant cupboard can really release the pressure in other parts of the house.
Clearing clutter is now my number one priority for this busy family. But when planning your storage, it's always important to consider how you will actually use it.
Here, you've got either a mirror and a shelf to the right.
Yeah.
Or a cupboard which opens up and the mirror's internal on the side.
And the shelf would have, like, all my products.
All your products in, everything.
Makeup.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everything.
Even though the clutter is a family-wide issue, today we're focusing on Sarah. And I suspect even a whole room of storage won't be enough to house all her clothes. So time for a clear out.
Welcome to Kirstie's Declutter Clinic. Sarah's cupboard in her room is just over 3 times the length of this. So basically, it's got to go into donate or sell if we get to more than 3 times the width of this. OK? Right. Okie dokie. Oh, look. Oh, look at your face. OK, so this is going to be really fast. Dump it down.
The key here is to be ruthless. If you love something but you never actually use it, let it go.
I've never seen her wear that, ever.
I've worn it a lot, but I don't think I'll wear it again.
OK.
Donate.
Okie dokie. This is going really well.
Do you think?
Yeah.
Keep, because I've only just got that.
Right, hang it.
Yeah. One more box.
And anything that's not suitable for the charity shops can go to fabric recycling, so nothing is wasted.
OK, so, have I established enough of a principle
yes.
here that I can leave you to it?
I don't feel like I can do it on my own, but you have.
No, don't worry, you got me.
Right.
Good, this is therapeutic. I like it.
Thank you.
Hokey dokey. The escalating cost of building work is a very serious matter. But in this case, it might have had a bit of a happy ending. Spending less might gain them more, and doesn't mean Phil has it in the bag.
2 months later, the carpenters have been hard at work creating storage solutions to fit each room, including a coat cupboard in the hall and a media wall in the living room to keep everything organised. They've kept costs down by using MDF, which can be painted to fit with the colour scheme of the room, with the total cost of all the units coming in at around £4,700, I think that's money well spent.
Back on the house hunt, as I expected, finding a bigger house in an area close to the schools is proving difficult. So I've got just one last chance to find a happy compromise and get Jabs on side. But today, he's brought back up in the form of daughter Mimi Ray.
Hello, good morning.
Hello, Phil.
Mimi, very nice to meet you.
Which camp are you in, love or list?
Love. Love? Oh, come on, Mum.
I know.
Like father, well. Like daughter.
Well, listen, let's crack on. I've got a really, really good house to show you. Cool. Follow me.
Okay. My final offering is back in Appleton, a short distance from school with plenty of amenities on the doorstep. So the perfect place to bring up two growing children.
Jabs, you're in so much trouble today. So much trouble.
We'll see.
So, what do you think? It's five bedrooms. It has, I think... Well, I think you're going to be wild inside.
OK. The outside looks good.
It looks very big.
Yeah.
So, can't wait to see.
Are you more comfortable here in this area?
Yeah, yes. Really, yeah.
Josiah's got friends in this area and it's yeah. not too far from his school.
Where is Josiah this morning?
He's playing football.
I actually knew that. And there was a football pitch just over there.
Is there?
Yeah. The garden here is a little bit on the small side, but there is a football pitch just there.
Oh, you're sneaky, okay. Phil. You're very sneaky.
So they're happy with the area. And I'm pretty sure this house will check off everything else on the wish list. On the market for £550,000, it's the top of their budget, but it's almost 50% bigger than their own house and offers all the living space thereafter. There's a spacious open-plan kitchen-diner, a separate lounge, utility and WC, and an office on the ground floor.
Right then, Mimi, see what you think of this?
Oh.
Not... I don't need to say much, because I think this house sells itself.
Oh, my goodness. I didn't expect Whoa. This. Wow. Mimi!
£550,000 on budget.
Okay.
Massive, massive open plan kitchen.
Yeah.
Five bedrooms, two bathrooms upstairs. Living room, office for two, downstairs loo, beautiful utility room,
Ooh.
Plus the garage. So, I mean, it really has everything.
Wow. They have sacrificed the hallway, though, haven't they?
Yeah, they have.
But I can look past that for now.
Can't have everything.
No.
Mimi, what do you reckon?
I like it, but I'm still on Daddy's side.
You're still on Daddy's side. That's OK. Is this what you had in your mind's eye in terms of open plan main room?
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Good. Let's go see the office.
While Jabs has to share his workspace at home, here he could have a dedicated room to himself, and there's plenty of space to store all of his equipment.
This obviously works incredibly well for Mr. and Mrs. as an office. I don't know whether you'd use it as an office or it could be a dining room because you've got five bedrooms.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
You could have a workspace up there.
That's an option.
It is.
Yeah. Mimi, what would you like to see next?
Bedrooms upstairs.
Fine, let's do it. You can choose one.
Jump on.
Sarah doesn't seem as keen as she did with the last house, but it's an example of the sort of property they could afford in an area they like. And with all the space thereafter downstairs, plus five bedrooms and two bathrooms upstairs, surely this is going to be hard to turn down.
Oh, this is cute.
It's quite a big room as well. I like the view.
It's a lovely view, and there's loads of places to put your things, loads of storage.
Yeah.
Should we go and see where Josiah's going to sleep?
Yeah, the smallest room.
Now the plans have been scaled down at home, I think Jabs is feeling on the back foot a bit, which is probably why he's brought Mimi along today as backup. But even the two of them are going to struggle to argue against this house.
Oh, this is nice. Ooh, it's got an ensuite. Oh,
this is where you two are going to sleep.
Is it?
Yeah.
Good thing about this place is there's lots of light.
Yeah.
Need a bit of updating.
Yeah, modernising.
I could do my DIY.
Yeah.
Yeah, but are you actually going to do any DIY?
Probably not, yeah.
After a year of moving in, oh, I might do my DIY now.
It's a good space, though.
Well, it seems Mimi Ray might have switched sides, Jabs. I'm hoping she'll be equally impressed with the garden.
OK. It's nice. Decently sized.
Yeah.
Wow.
I like it.
Could you play football on this? Well, I don't think you could.
Do you think Josiah would like it?
Yeah, I think it's too small for...
But there is a pitch round there.
Yeah, but... Yeah.
And then this can just be my netball area.
Yeah.
How are you guys getting on?
Good.
Good.
Bad luck, Jabs. What do you think, Mimi?
I like it.
This house is 50% larger than yours is.
Okay.
But it demonstrates that 550 grand does buy you...
Yeah, it's a lot of space.
But in terms of the layout and the space, value for money, position, distance to schools, numbers of rooms...
Yes.
Yeah, it's ticking most of the boxes.
Yeah, it is.
Let's leave it there.
I think the process has been quite interesting because it has opened our eyes to see what's out there and to see what we can actually get for our money as well. And knowing that if we do decide to list, which we probably won't, we have lots of options.
I'm really pleased with that house and their reaction to it as well. They had a challenging brief, and that was made particularly hard by restrictions both to budget and to schools. But actually, we've had a really strong finish. And I think Kirstie might be buying the drinks.
Don't be so sure, Phil. Just wait until you lay eyes on the transformation back at home.
Back in Cheshire, after 7 months of turmoil, it's time to find out if Jabs and Sarah have decided to love their four-bed family home or up sticks for somewhere new.
So they had to really kind of wind back their plans, I hear.
Yeah.
Difficult choices.
Really difficult choices.
But I guess that's what everybody we work with had.
But we've all come to a point now where we expect a lot from our houses.
Yes, absolutely.
We want them to look a certain way, be a certain way. We want to do
gyms,
lots of different...
Gyms, offices, schools.
Yeah, things in them. And so that's hard because, you know, how do we manage all of that?
By moving to a new house?
I wouldn't get your hopes up, Phil. Just wait until you see what they've managed to achieve.
This type of gravel wrecks your heels. I got my posh shoes on.
What, do you want me to carry you?
No, 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 it's OK. There we are.
Hello. Oh, nice to see you again.
Nice to be here.
Oh, look at you. All coordinated.
Look at you. It's gorgeous as ever.
Very worried about ruining her heels on your gravel.
Oh, well, that is.
There we are.
I hope you're ready for this, Phil.
What have we got?
Look.
When we were first here, the living space was cluttered, and Sarah hated everything out in the open. But by spending just £1,200 on colourful, custom-built storage units and rejigging the furniture, it's like a completely different room.
Storage is the absolute key to what's happened in this house.
It's what we needed.
It's just amazing how storage has just changed the way we live.
Yeah.
Such a small change.
Yeah, can I have that on repeat? In fact, I might make that my ringtone. Because you are such a busy family.
Mm.
You've got so many different commitments.
Yeah.
And actually knowing where everything is... Mm. Everything having a home is just the solution.
After scaling back on their original budget, Sarah and Jabs kept costs to an absolute minimum and in the end only spent a total of around £5,000 on carpentry and decorating.
I don't think anyone has ever spent so little on achieving so much since we first started doing this job.
Because you did have to kind of backpedal or backtrack on what was possible.
We did. Yeah.
What should have been about 15 or 20,000 was doubled, if not tripled.
Yeah.
And we're not prepared to do that.
Has it helped you live in a different way?
Definitely.
That's definitely, yeah.
It is looking super sharp.
Yeah.
It's all flowing really well. And you haven't spent £30,000 or £40,000.
£40,000, yeah, on a small space.
On a small space.
Have you done things upstairs?
Yes, we have.
Yeah. Okay. Come and see, Phil.
Excited.
While high prices put a stop to our plans for a new staircase, 9-year-old Mimi Ray has happily made the loft room her fun new bedroom. And that's freed up the box room to become a super functional new dressing room. Complete with flat pack wardrobes built by Sarah and Jabs, and Sarah's dressing table, which has been moved here from the main bedroom to free up more space in there too.
More storage?
Yeah.
Very effective storage.
And whose stuff is it?
It's both of ours. Yeah. Mostly mine.
It was supposed to be just Jabs'
Well, supposed to be mostly mine.
I got a little section.
Somehow I don't believe you. But has it taken the pressure off your room?
Yeah, it has.
Right. Can we move along?
Yeah.
And where the main bedroom used to be packed in tightly with no space for their clothes, by swapping the super king-size bed for a double, they've regained almost 30% of that floor space. And moving the dressing table into the box room has made way for a more generous wardrobe, so the whole room looks neater and better proportioned.
It does look really nice, doesn't it?
Yeah.
That is really pretty, that curtain.
Yeah.
It's very neat and tidy.
Yeah.
Did you know we were coming or something?
I don't know how long it'll stay like this.
I was going to say, it's going to stay like this for long.
As long as you can make it look presentable for new buyers, Jabs.
Don't get carried away, Phil. There's still the sitting room to see.
Do you know what? I think this is the biggest transformation.
As the only separate space on the ground floor, this room was working very hard, doubling up as a teenage gaming room, as well as Jabs's home office and a place to store his equipment. But by mounting the TV, freshening up the colour and fitting fantastic new full-size cupboards for £530, it's become a much more organised space that still does everything they need it to do, just better.
The TV looks great. It's all a smooth operation. Sometimes people come to us and they say, this is a problem, this is a problem, this is a problem.
Yeah. Mm.
But actually, the problem is more fundamental, and it's just you've got a very busy life.
Yes.
And you couldn't quite work out what was preventing that smoothly. It's like we've greased the tracks.
It flows better.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Yes, I completely see that. That the house was under a lot of pressure.
Yes.
And that put you under pressure and the family under pressure. Giving everything a home has absolutely eased that. But your key problems were bathrooms, bedrooms.
Mm. I think we need to sit down. Come on.
Okay.
Sarah and Jabs aren't giving much away, so I'm intrigued to hear what they've decided to do.
I think it's fair to say that we ran into some problems with distance to school on the search.
Yeah.
We did.
But I also think it's fair to say we saw some pretty special houses.
We did.
That offered a lot.
Yeah.
And therefore demonstrated that it is achievable.
It was good to see what was out there, I guess, and, you know, see what we could get for our money.
Yes, so it did make me start to dream a bit.
You spent £5,000.
Yeah.
Yeah.
On the storage, the units, everything. And you've added £10,000 to the value of this house.
Mm. Have we?
Yeah.
No, I didn't know
that. The revaluations came in at £10,000 more.
Wow.
Probably because they can see it all now.
I think that is a real lesson to us all.
Yeah. Yes.
That what sells is something looking sharp.
Yeah.
It looks sharp now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you reached a decision easily?
No,
we haven't.
Have you reached a decision?
Because things were a lot different a couple of months ago when we started this project,
yeah,
that is really swaying our decision.
Well, I suppose we should ask.
Yes, let's get it over with.
So, Jabs, Sarah, are you going to love it?
Or list it?
We're going to list it.
Were you going to say love it?
But
we are not in a rush. So we're not. We love the house as it is now. It works for us. So we have to find the dream house in the right location, with the open plan kitchen and the garden that's not overlooked.
So how are you
How are you feeling about that decision? Because you were pretty rooted here.
Yeah, I was quite rooted here, but at the end of the day, the kids are getting bigger. Mm. Yeah. So we definitely need more space.
They are out there. What you're trying to find, budget, location, it is achievable.
Yeah.
There'll be a compromise somewhere.
Yeah, there definitely will be, but I think with the core things that we need, I think those...
Yeah. It's doable.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Well done.
Thank you.
Good decision.
Thanks for all your help.
Thank you for your help. Just chuffed that he's got a list.
I am indeed. But you have to agree, Kirstie, it's the best decision for this family long term.
I feel quite happy about the future because we're not desperate to move. It's going to be quite easy to keep things tidy with all the storage.
And also after Phil's help as well, we know what we're looking for.
Yeah.
We kind of solidified the core things that we definitely want to have in the house we're going to move into.
I don't like the pink though.
Yeah, but
it's a girly.
It's not girly, it's like a peachy pink.
Thank you.
Cheers. Congratulations, Phil.
I'm pleased. I think they've made
totally
the right decision.
Yeah. I'm pleased too. I'm genuinely pleased too. Yeah.
Big sigh of relief from Phil.
If you'd like our help deciding whether to love it or list it, apply online at channel4.com/takepart. You're on a roll, Phil, and that puts you 3-2 in the lead. So I've got some catching up to do next time.
What about numbers of bedrooms, though?
Numbers of bedrooms is not something I can change.
When we meet a big family who can't see any way forward.
Is it really worth it? Is that what we actually want to do?
Can we get them everything they want? Or will compromise be the only solution?
We are going to